can't. This is something all of us have heard at one point or another in our lives. You can't do this because you are this. You can't like this because you are this. Stereotypes and discrimination are all around us. We have two options in a situation like this. Either we can accept the stereotypes and hide the things we shouldn't like because of who we are, or we can persevere and follow our dreams. Today, I would like to tell you about someone who followed her dreams and didn't let anyone stand in her way, even from a very young age. Captain Beverly Bass. Beverly Bass was born on a horse ranch in Florida, and when she was 8 years old, her parents went on a trip and left her in the care of her aunt, who took her to the airport so that they could watch the planes take off and land. Bass wanted to go for a ride on a plane. They were offering rides for a penny a pound, which meant that you would pay one penny for every pound that you weighed. So she scrounged up a bunch of change, and finally she had enough, and her aunt said no. She said that her parents had left Bass in her care and she wasn't going to let anything happen to her. Beverly Bass later told interviewers that this was the only fight she and her aunt would ever have. When she was young, she asked for rides to Fort Myers so that she could watch the planes land every night. And even from age 8, she knew that she wanted to be a part of it. She knew that she wanted to be on those planes. She wanted to be flying the planes. She wanted to be in the air. And when she was 16 years old, she asked her father if she could take flying lessons, but he said no, because he was afraid it would interfere with raising horses and working on the ranch. And as she was 16 and he was a father, he thought that working on the ranch would keep boys away. So that's why he wanted her to work there. Beverly Bass went to college at TCU, which is Texas Christian University. Some friends of her father introduced her to the school, and since she didn't want to go to a large university and she loved Texas, she decided to enroll. At the time, she was majoring in interior design and Spanish, but she still had dreams of being a pilot. She still wanted to be in the air. So while she was in college, she arranged all of her classes so that she could be free by the afternoon, every afternoon. And she would go to the airport, and she would hang around at the airport, and she would take flying lessons. She got her first job senior year, her first flying job senior year, flying for a mortician, which meant that she would fly dead bodies from where they died to where they were going to be buried. And she absolutely loved it. She was finally in the air. There was nobody to complain that she couldn't do it because the only other people on the plane were corpses. But she was still shot down for many jobs. She was once quoted as saying, "I was told there couldn't be a female pilot flying executives around because what would the wives think?" Eventually, however, she got an interview with American Airlines and was then hired as their third ever female pilot. She moved to New York, where she roomed with flight attendants, as they were the only other women, and they were kind of skeptical of her at first because they thought that she thought that she was better than them somehow, that being a flight attendant was beneath her and that's why she wanted to be a pilot. But she didn't. That was not her mentality at all, and eventually they became very good friends and they're all still friends today. In 1986, Beverly Bass became American Airlines' first ever female captain, and later that year, she led the first all-female crew in aviation history. At that time, female pilots, were barely even heard of. But an entirely female crew stopped the presses. I'd like to show you this graph. Can everybody see it again? So an ATP is the highest certification that a pilot can earn. So if you look for the red bars at the top are male ATPs. The yellow line right below the red bar is a female ATP, which is what Bass was. If you look in the 1980s, which is this one, that little yellow bar is about that big. You can barely even see it. Before then, it was non-existent. Commercial pilots, the light green is female and the darker green is male. And the light green is about that big in the 1980s. And if you look at the 2010s, even today it is a tiny fraction of the amount. According to a 2016 statistic, less than 7% of all pilots, now this means ATPs, commercial, not for hire, even students, less than 7% of all pilots are female. But even after she had gotten this job and she had become a captain, and she had led the first all-female crew in aviation history, her obstacles didn't stop there. In 2001, while flying from Paris to Dallas, Bass had to divert her plane to land in Gander, Newfoundland, Canada. The US airspace had been closed for the first time in history on September 11th. And overnight, the population in Gander had nearly doubled, jumping from 9,000 people to almost 16,000 people. In the 38 planes that landed on September 11th in Canada, there were 7,000 people that suddenly the citizens of Gander had to take care of. Bass was able to keep the passengers and crew of her plane calm during the 21 hours that they were on the ground, unable to leave the plane. Terrorists had used something that she loved, that she used for good, that she used to help people travel, to reach their families. They had used that, and they had used it as a weapon. They had used it to hurt people, to kill people, including one of her friends, who was the captain of the plane that crashed into the Pentagon that day. But she didn't let that stop her. She returned to Texas 5 days after the attack, and the airport refused to let her come into work, saying that she should take a few days off. She tried to come back, and she tried to come back every day as she called them, and she was back in the airport flying again by Thursday, and she flew for another 10 years before she retired. I first learned about Captain Bass while listening to the musical Come From Away, which is about what happened in those 5 days in Canada following the September 11th attacks. And her story just really struck a chord with me. My whole life I've been told that I can't do things because of who I am, both blatantly and subtly. One of the most common ones I've heard is, can I have some guys to help move things? Which implies that even if it's light, like chairs, moving tables, that girls just can't do it simply because they're girls. I've also heard that you shouldn't wear heels and aren't you tall enough already? Not from people who were trying to bully me, but from my friends. They told me that I should not wear heels, not that maybe you should wear heels less, or maybe you should think about wearing something else. I wear heels for two reasons. I'm about 6 feet tall without the heels, and I wear heels for two reasons. One, because I also have very large feet. I'm about size 12, so all those cutesy little shoes that you find in size 7, you can't find them in my size. So heels are pretty much what I can find. And the second reason is because I like them. I like wearing heels. I like the sound they make when I cross hardwood floors. I like how I look in them. I know I stand taller. And I like how they look on me. Another one I heard was, you intimidate guys because you're tall and loud. And this implied that in order to get a guy, I needed to stop wearing heels. And I needed to stop voicing my opinions and stop sharing knowledge that I had, and that I had to change something about myself in order to get somebody to like me. Also, sometimes I'm hesitant to audition for shows that I really want to be in. I love acting, it's my dream, but I've kind of been had those dreams almost crushed just because of how tall I am, which is something that I cannot help. I usually can't play a lead. Yeah.
Take a deep breath. You're doing amazing.
Thank you. Usually I can't play a lead, especially if it's a love interest, because most of the time I'm taller than the guy playing the male love interest, and that looks bad. I was once in Into the Woods. And before auditions started, I was told by the director of the show, I see you as the baker's wife. I think you're gonna be the baker's wife. This was the director of the show. I didn't get cast as the baker's wife because the Cinderella's prince was about my height, but the baker went to about here on me. He was itty bitty. I got cast as Cinderella's wicked stepmother, which was a fun role, but it was kind of hard for me to look past for a while. Because I had been told that I was, pretty much told that I was going to get a role that I didn't get, that I was really looking forward to. Mm-hmm. So it's been kind of beaten into my mind that I can't be a successful actress because I'm tall. But Captain Bass has inspired me to follow my dreams no matter what anybody else thinks. And I may not have gone through as many trials as she did. I mean, I'm only 18. but she inspires me to give up, to not give up on my dreams, no matter what anyone else tells me or thinks. Captain Beverly Bass knew what she wanted to do from the time she was very little. She stuck to her dreams, and she didn't let anyone tell her what she couldn't do. Even when someone used this dream of hers to hurt people, she got right back up and showed everyone that she would not be defeated. Captain Bass inspires me to follow my dreams, and I hope she inspires you to do the same. Always remember, your whole life, people will try to tell you what you can or can't do. It's up to you whether or not you listen.